joined by our leading man. How are you, sir?
I'm not too bad. How are you?
And leading lady. Are you coming in too, Cameron? Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Very well, and yourself?
What an incredible reaction.
A sudden scream for the person coming up behind me. Yes. Hello, darling.
What a great reaction. And the world premiere here in London. Kind of had to be, didn't it?
Well, it always is. Leicester Square is always the best. Absolutely. Every time. Every premiere I've had here has been wonderful. Great crowd.
Yeah, great crowd and a great film. Congratulations. It's an old-fashioned comedy. Yeah. Would you agree?
Yes, it is. It's vintage farce. This is not groundbreaking. This is comfort comedy. Not easy to do, but out of the manual. This is more, I think, Blake Edwards meets Noises Off or something. It's, you know.
Coen Brothers' script, though, as well, which just kind of gives it that edge, I think, as well. Would you agree?
Absolutely. I mean, no one does it better. Their words are so much fun to say. Their characters are always perfectly toned and perfectly broad for, you know, the tone of the film. And it's a lot of fun to bring them to life.
Now, I believe that when your director first approached you about this, sir, you were like, I don't want to do a comedy. Is that right?
No, it's not true. I did want to do a comedy.
Lies!
Yeah, no, I just didn't know if I wanted to work with him. That'll teach him to quote me. No,
It's been said out loud.
Yeah, I can't remember how that conversation went. But,
what was it that made you kind of go, yeah, this is the one I want to do?
I just thought, I you work in one tone for a while, and it's quite nice to change the tone, and I felt this was, you know, a good opportunity to do that. It had a great pedigree attached to it, and, you know, once we started to get the people together that were going to participate, including Michael, I think it seemed to be a good thing to take a roll of the dice on.
Great cast.
I'm glad you did.
Not just you guys as well, but Alan and Tom as well, in terms of, it's like a circle of chemistry between you all and those roles that you all have with each other. And
did you talk to Tom Corn?
Not yet, but I hear you're a big fan.
Oh my God.
Did he woo you?
He totally wooed me. he seduced me, like, immediately. I was like, what is happening here? What is really going on? Why am I in love with Tom Courtney right now? Like, how did
wait to meet him. Where is Major? I'm like, I need to meet this
He's
man.
Amazing.
Yeah, little Major. He'll be hiding out somewhere.
And you, sir, last thing, there's another award you're going to pick up for this film that you haven't yet picked up. We know you've got a few best legs in the business.
Oh,
hello.
The legs thing.
Hello.
Oh, really? Are we talking? Yes, I I did have a bit of leg anxiety at the time. I mean,
you've got a good teacher standing next to you in terms of leg anxiety.
I just laughed at him. I just pointed and I laughed.
Helpful. No, it's one thing to basically drop everything, but just the trousers. It's just not the look that's recommended for a chap, really. Suit, tie, brogues, socks up to the knees, underpants and nothing else. Don't know if you can work that, you can probably just get away with anything.
And I love the clash of cultures in this film in terms of the Britishness and the Americanness. It just works to perfection, really. Was that a lot of fun to play with?
Absolutely. I mean, that's sort of the crux of the whole comedy. You know, that's these two people sort of thrown together, and their inability to really communicate and understand one another. They both speak English, but, you know, they just have no ability to communicate, and they're driven by different things. So it's a lot of fun to play that.
Well, congratulations. It's a great film, and enjoy this world premiere here in London. Thank you very much, Carmen and Colin. Thank you.
Where I can have all the love.
spans more than 50 years. Gambit was shot mainly on location in and around London. The story centres on Harry Dean, played by Colin Firth,
and darling, then I read again.